Hey everyone, Victor here from Growth Evolution Development Ground. And straight away, please excuse me for the quality of the sound and the video. I have broken my camera, and because of the quarantine, I haven't been able to go to the stores and buy a new one yet. So I'm just using my laptop to make this video. I just really wanted to make it. I don't do videos very often these days, mostly because I focus on the written part of my blog. But every once in a while I do like to make a video, and this is one of those days. And also, please excuse me for my pretty nose. If you do martial arts, you know that you always get scratches and bruises, so that's that. So what is this video going to be about? This video is going to be about DCA. And what is DCA, if you don't know? It's Digital Course Academy. And Digital Course Academy is a program made by Amy Porterfield that teaches you how to make a digital course based on your skills, knowledge, experience, and so on. And why am I making this video? Well, first of all, is because I have gone through the program. I know what the program is about. Also because Amy Porterfield is, well, she's my guide, basically, my teacher. And also because I really do believe, like I said, I really do believe in this program, and I also think that this is the best time to make an online course because of the whole situation with COVID, with the whole pandemic, everybody's at home. Self-education has become really like a, well, not really self-education, but also self-education, but just education in general through the internet, through the computer. It's like a really big thing. And if you look in the trends, even in those countries where the where they now allow you to leave home and stuff, the trends of how people are educating, it's not going down, the online education, it's still going up. Actually, people are now kind of like, the world has changed, people are now used to it. So you may have seen, if not, check it out. I made a review of Digital Course Academy last year, and I straight away, I loved the course, but the thing is, at that moment, yet, I have not even, well, I think I just started making my course. I'm not even sure, actually, did I even start making my course then? But anyway, I went through the program, I checked it out, and I thought it's the best online, genuinely, it's the best online course I have ever gone through, and I have gone through quite a lot. And in this video, I just wanted to really talk about my experience with actually making my own digital course according to DCA's, according to the DCA program, like according to what Amy teaches, my experience. Well, first of all, I want to say that I was really hesitant to buy the course because I thought, like, what am I going to make my course about? Like, do I have any skills? But then, you know, I thought, like, what do I really love in my life? What do I love doing? What do I really have experience with? What is my hobby? And vlogging is my hobby. It's been something I've been doing since 2016. And I thought, and I'm also a web developer, so I actually also know how to code websites. And, you know, a blog is also a website. So I thought, like, maybe I'll combine those two and see where it takes me. And I thought, like, yes, I'm going to do a course around blogging. And so, and by the way, the reason also why I'm making this video right now is because Amy Porterfield is about to launch her DCA once again in September, in the early September. And she does this only once a year, so this is also the reason why I'm making this video right now in, I think it's August. In August, yeah. So yeah, I didn't really know what to make my course about. I was hesitant to buy DCA, but I bought it anyway because I kind of figured out I'm going to make my course around blogging. And so I bought the course, and it was really cool because Amy actually took me, she teaches in her course how to come up with the perfect course idea. And I came up with mine. And in case you don't know, I'm making a course around blogging from A to Z. So how to pick a niche all the way up to when you have your blog up and running with all the plugins and everything, your WordPress blog, and how to create content and SEO and even more complicated stuff. It's a lot of material, but that's how I wanted to do it. So in case you're interested in blogging, let me know down in the comments below. So yeah, I started going through the course, and you know, it was kind of like I was putting it away, putting it away. I was putting it away for a year. But then some time ago, well, now about half a year ago, I started really focusing on my course. And you know, like I said, I was hesitant, but my hands, like I just told myself, do it. And I started doing it, and it actually turned out not that hard. Well, I mean, it is, it does take time. It's not effortless. And by no, but, you know, it really does take time. That's just something I really have to get out there. And so I started doing it and recording videos, and this is another thing that I was really worried about. I would think I had this idea that I would need this super professional gear all around me in order for it to work. But AIM actually teaches that if this is something you're doing for the first time and your course is not a very expensive course or you want to keep it simple, you can even use your, you can do what I'm doing right now. You don't even have to show your face. Like in my course, I'm using a lot of my computer. I'm capturing the screen all the time because that's what you need to see. You don't need to see my face when you're learning about blogging. So this is what really made me excited that I don't have to spend all that money on all the gear. I mean, you can if you really want to, but you don't have to. And so I started making my course, and now I'm in the process of I'm almost finished with the course. The only thing to do left is to launch it. And basically, if I go back to my review last year of the course, I still feel the same way about it. I still think that AIM is an amazing teacher. I think it's one of the best courses. It is the best course that I've ever gone through. And that if you're thinking of going online, like you're leaving your job and going online sooner or later, if you're, you know, you want to quit the 9 to 5 and stuff like that, then I would say this is the best time to purchase DCA. And I'm not, like, I truly believe in what I'm saying, and this is exactly the reason why I started to make my course really fast right now, is because this is the best time to make the course. And so what's really cool is that also Amy has decided to update the core of the course. So she's looked at, you know, how her students have been going through the course last year, and she decided to make an update of it. So if you go to my review of last year, it's going to be a little different, the core, because I don't know what it is, how it's going to be yet, because she hasn't yet released it, but she will soon. And like when if you purchase it in September, you're going to get the new version, and that's, you know, pretty nice of her. You know, not many teachers go back to their course a year later to update basically the whole course. And so my experience with it is really positive. There's, like I said, it's not an easy thing. It's not a, like, you're not gonna do the course in a week time. It takes some time. And also, it's not a get rich quick thing, for sure. There are people in the Facebook group who have earned millions with their online courses, but it takes time. It takes time, it takes experience. And if you're thinking also, which is what I was thinking, if you're thinking like, I don't have anything to teach, there's always something everybody has that they could teach others and that others would want to pay money for. This is a self-limiting belief that I had that very, very many students have. And I suggest you let that go, sit down, take a piece of paper, and write a list of things that you are interested in, that you've been doing, that you've maybe taught others, and so on. This is what I did. This is how I ended up with blogging. So this is in a nutshell that I what I wanted to basically talk about today. But before you go and buying the course, if that's what you really want to do, I suggest you take Amy's new quiz, which she's just released. It's a really great quiz. It takes only 2 minutes, and the idea is that there's three approaches towards making a profitable digital course based on your experience, your knowledge, and so on. And that course will tell you, you go through the, or that quiz, I'm sorry, you go through the quiz and you will find out which approach you should take or whether you're ready for making a digital course at all. I'll leave the link to that quiz down below in the comments, in the description, and I'll also leave the link to my last year's review. So you get maybe you're in the same place I was last year, like what I talk about. So I suggest that you maybe check out that video as well. So I'll leave those two links there, and that was all for today. I hope you found this video useful. If you have, just, you know, thumbs up. And if you have any questions regarding course creation or blogging, also just write them down in the comments. I always reply to comments. So that was it. Thank you, and I hope to see you in the next video.